when I came to the door of Islam, I thought, you know, why not try this? I didn't know really that it was a lifetime, you know, commitment. I have been identifying myself as Muslim by choice for half a century. When I first became Muslim, people used to accuse me of being from the West. And I'm like, well, Allah is the Lord of the East and the West. I don't understand why that would make a difference, you know? But it was meant to say that I could never really be Muslim because I guess being born Muslim is all you have. Tendency to have the positionality of women to be below men. Oh my God, it was just rampant, you know? But the Quran doesn't do that. And my experience with this was quite intuitive. I was not starting a revolution. I mean, I can look back now and say, oh, that really was quite revolutionary. But I didn't do it because I was trying to be the first in anything. I was simply so invested in this experience that I was having with the Quran that I thought there must be a way that I can articulate this. And you don't have to be a Quran scholar to say, you know what? The whole idea of beating a woman, I just can't abide by. I currently identify as non-binary. I identify as queer. The binary understanding of gender is dysfunctional. It doesn't make better marriages. It doesn't prevent sexual violence. People have been grappling with this binary in so many ways, and only Muslims are lagging behind, pretending there is no conversation to be had. And as such, we have this huge estrangement in our community for the lived realities of people who do not identify with those binary. I hope to have been a part of a conversation where we accept that sexual diversity is as much a part of us as different colors of our eyes, and no more harmful than that.